security camera's been on for a very long time.
It wasn't on this morning.
I believe it's on now. So if you decided to pick your nose in the last hour or so, they got that. One minute.
No Johnson tonight?
No Johnson tonight. He's in Delaware. He claims to have told us, but I don't remember it, and Daryl doesn't remember it. I don't suppose it matters much. Today, I talked to him and he said he was in Delaware. I'm like, okay. Must be, right? Seconds.
I don't think we could have planned this any better. The onion that's running, or no, it's the whitest kid you know.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live. And you can call in and talk about, well, whatever's on your mind. Now, it's Mark with you.
And Daryl.
And it's Constitution Day, Daryl.
Yes, it is.
This is the day that we're to celebrate the Constitution of the United States of America, the oldest governing document on the planet. And, you know, Americans, they revere this document. They know they revere it a great deal. They think that it's an important document.
I'm confused about your statement, the oldest governing document in the world.
My understanding is that
the Constitution for the state of New Hampshire is older than the U.S. Constitution.
Yeah, I think they're referring to a nation as opposed to a state. But
okay.
Yeah, you're right that the Constitution for a few states is older. You know, the Constitution's been amended, so isn't it only as old as its last amendment?
In theory.
Yeah, so I don't know on that. And I suppose the Magna Carta is still in place, right?
Technically.
Why isn't that a governing document? I don't know entirely what people
mean. Well, because the Magna Carta is only partially what governs the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. Their constitution is not actually written down. So it's like, you know, taking from documents here and there and then tradition, and we make it up as we go along.
Gotcha. So Americans, they revere the Constitution. It's an important document to them.
A lot of them do.
Yeah, and they know a great deal about it, right?
People like to think that they do.
Okay.
There was a study that was done by the American Council of Trustees and Alumni, and they released these results about a week and a half ago, and, well, I thought it would be very relevant to bring it in today since it's Constitution Day.
What results?
They found that college graduates don't know some basic facts about the U.S. Constitution.
They don't know that the First Amendment grants you the right to have a pet?
They may have thought that. I will get into some of the results of the survey.
They're not clear that the Constitution clearly states that you have to fight for your right to party?
They may know that. They also, according to the study here, 10% of college graduates think that Judith Sheindlin, you know her,
no,
Judge Judy.
No. Is that her?
Judge Judy. Her real name is Judith Sheindlin.
Well, good for her.
10% of college graduates thought she was a sitting member of the U.S. Supreme Court.
Okay.
One-third could not identify the Bill of Rights as a name, or rather as the name given to a group of constitutional amendments. 32% believe that John Boehner is the current president of the U.S. Senate. And shockingly, 46% of college graduates don't know the election cycle, 6 years for a senator, 2 years for a member of the U.S. House of Representatives. Turning to the general population, the report finds that over half, 54%, cannot identify the Bill of Rights accurately, and 11% of people aged 25 to 34 believe the Constitution must be reauthorized every 4 years.
Well, that's funny. Every 2 years, they have to authorize spending for the military as per
yes.
the Constitution. So, sometimes the questions that they ask in these circumstances can be tough, right? So, like, if somebody says, name the five things that are laid out as rights in the First Amendment, right? Like, it's going to be difficult for the average American to come up with, I'm going to give it a shot here without looking. Yeah.
I will ask you the question because they do ask a question about the First Amendment. The question they asked, which of the following is not protected by the First Amendment?
Okay.
Free speech.
Okay.
Right to an education.
Okay.
Right to petition the government. Freedom of assembly.
Well, pretty clear that it's a right to an education, but these people are told their whole lives that they have a right to an education. They're given an education in the government school system. I'll grant you it's the worst school usually in a given geographic area, but they're told that that's their right. And so I'm not surprised that they don't know. And also,
84% actually wound up getting that one right.
That's good.
10% thought that you did not have a right to petition the government, or at least did not think that that was protected by the First Amendment.
Frankly, you don't. You know, try to petition for redress of grievances. Now, the petition for redress of grievances was essentially done away with in the 1800s because abolitionists kept on writing letters to Congress, and Congress just decided we're not going to respond to these. Because at one point they were read aloud and Congress responded. Now, that was back when Congress didn't have nearly as much to do.
Right.
The only thing the federal government did was sort of regulate trade between states, which once it's laid down, then everything's basically fine. And then, you know, prosecute a war here and there.
There was actually a Supreme Court case, or there was potentially a Supreme Court case a couple of years ago. Do you remember the We the People Foundation?
Yes.
They attempted to get the U.S. Supreme Court to rule on the right of petition for redress of grievance.
Yes.
Supreme Court denied hearing the case. They issued an order, we're not going to hear this. And in their order, they basically said, you have a right to petition, but there is no requirement for any government agent anywhere to respond to your petition.
Well, that's effectively it, right? Like this is what it's reduced to in the United States. You have the right to complain. Millions of men and women in arms have died for your right to complain. We will let you complain about whatever it is you wish to complain about, but that's it. That's all you got for rights.
And if you complain too loudly, then somebody might tell you, move to Somalia.
It's true. Somebody will certainly tell you to move to Somalia.
Or Korea. Like I got Korea one time. Moved to Korea.
The best response to that, if somebody tells you to move to Somalia, is what gave you the impression that I'd want to move to a place where you know, every attempt at governance has been destroyed by the UN and the United States over the course of half a decade, and where you know, their socialist policies were undermined from the very beginning. What makes you think I wanted to go there in the first place?
Right.
But the person who is so silly as to have told you to move to Somalia, they're not thinking about that anyway. They just
don't
want
realize
you hair.
Well, most of those people don't realize that the problems in Somalia are caused from an overabundance of governments, not a lack of them.
It's true. But one thing I do kind of wonder, Daryl, is when I'm dealing with you know, like the socialist Democratic socialists, they're big right now because of Bernie Sanders.
Yes.
And that's fine. They're getting their day in the sun or whatever that is, and that's cool. But when people say everything's great in Sweden or Denmark or Norway or wherever it is, why don't we be more like that? I really have to ask myself, why don't you move there?
Because I was born on this plot of land, and this plot of land is better than all the other plots of land. We just need to make this plot of land more like some of those other plots.
Right. I mean, it's one thing if you're saying, hey, it's better someplace else. Well, then you should go there. Now, I'm not saying it's better someplace else. I'm saying that human freedom tends to result in the best things for everyone, whereas governments are antithetical, as we understand them today, are antithetical towards human freedom.
Yes.
So how do we realign human organizations around some new paradigm to create something better? And that's not going to be in Somalia, right? I mean,
right.
So that's a different story. Whereas if I'm sitting here and saying, you know what, everything's really nice in Denmark, we should be more like Denmark. We should make New Hampshire like Denmark. Why spend your whole life trying to reform some given government into the government you want to see when you could change your life immediately in the course of a plane ride and do that? If you have said to yourself that you want to see, you know, see wherever it is look more like Sweden or Denmark or whatever, please call in right now at 855-450-3733 and tell me, because I don't know, tell me why it is you don't pick up and move and you want to change things here and you bother people on Facebook about it. And Daryl, what do you got, a question about the Constitution?
There are a good many. I want to go through some of these questions that were asked.
Okay. And we'll get to your calls. It's 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. It's the username is lrn.fm on Skype. You can call us there. Sound really good. 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
every once in a while you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now. No other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. The number is 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. We're talking about Constitution Day here on Free Talk Live and going through some questions that were asked of folks in a poll to see what they sort of knew about the Constitution, which is to say, not that much.
Specifically college graduates.
College graduates. And, well, we're going to see what they have to say in this poll. Also, I asked the question sort of tertiarily is that if you think the world is better in, say, Denmark or Norway or wherever it might be, and I've heard this said and by, you know, mainly the folks that are pushing Bernie Sanders right now. Why don't you move there? Now, I'm not trying to be mean. I'm really asking a honest-to-God question is what's the reason? Why would you spend your whole life working against a system to bring about a change, maybe half a change or whatever, when you could just get an airplane and change your life for the better if there's some better place to be? And I want to know that. But if you want to reach people with the message of liberty, like I do, you should consider going to libertystickers.com because you can do it from the back of your car. You can reach thousands of people with a bumper sticker, and you know the people love to read them. You've found yourself inching forward in traffic to read a bumper sticker a little bit better. I've done it. You've done it. And you can put some really great messages on the back of your car. You can check out the vast selection of witty, poignant, pithy, and downright bombastic liberty-oriented messages at libertystickers.com. It's libertystickers.com. By the way, at libertystickers.com, they can make custom bumper stickers for you and your organizations, whatever they might be.
And if you buy 100 of the stickers that they have of their designs, mix and match, then you get those really cheap. I think it's right at $1 a sticker, and you can cover the entire back bumper, the trunk of your car, wrap around to the side. And then
it's a lot of stickers.
Really catch some eyes.
Yeah. LibertyStickers.com. Let's go to John calling in from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. John, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Oh, hey, guys. What's going on?
Not a lot. What's going on?
Oh, no, I just want to talk about the debate last night.
Yeah, I heard that the Republicans were discussing things with Donald Trump.
Yeah, they were. And, I like Donald Trump. You know, he has a lot of good qualities, especially all the stinky Mexicans were going, fuck you.
Well, we dumped you out there, buddy. Just so you know, that doesn't work.
Yeah.
If you're going to wait a long time to get on the air, you should know that we've got a dump button. Now, you can go and you can listen to the archive of the show on the internet where you can say naughty words all you want and you'll have heard it. But in reality, on FCC-licensed stations, your naughty words aren't going to change anything because I just dumped out 7 seconds of the show and bloop, his outburst is gone. So there you go. For folks that might be interested in attempting to, in some way, shape, or form, sabotage Free Talk Live's airing on 150 radio stations across the country, that isn't going to work.
Yes.
Maybe other things will. That one will not. And it's a waste of your time. So if you can't come out with something just slightly better and more exciting than saying the F-bomb, then, well, you know, that's it. Let's go to Mike calling in from Clackamas, Oregon. Mike, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, guys. I want to talk tonight about a movie my girlfriend and I watched last night called Jobs, the story about Steve Jobs and the Apple Corporation.
Okay.
And I was watching, I don't know if you guys are familiar with it, but about halfway through the movie, I don't want to ruin it for anybody, but he goes, you know, public with his company, Apple. And I noticed that the quote-unquote board of directors didn't like what Steve Jobs was doing. And they essentially pretty much fired him from his own company. Now, the company, I think, in reality, is the idea that was in his mind originally. And then, of course, he created computers and did programming or whatnot. How do you guys feel about a board of directors firing the head guy from his very own company? Because I have a problem with it. I don't find it to be right. I mean, I view things right and wrong, not so much legal and illegal and all that. What are your thoughts on this?
Well, let me ask you this. Let's say I sold you Free Talk Live, and you kept me on to kind of keep things running smoothly. And then at, you know, maybe 6 months or whatever, you decided you just can't work with me anymore. Would it be within your rights to fire me if I had, you know, I mean, I'd sold it to you for $1 million or whatever. I don't know what Free Talk Live's worth, but I'd certainly love to talk to you if you want to, if you got $1 million to throw around. You know, would it be within your rights to fire me in that circumstance?
Well, first off, I wouldn't fire you. I would try to work things out, but...
Well, you tried that for the first 6 months. Like, you just don't know. I'm an a-hole, right?
I can admit or confirm that.
Shut up, Daryl.
I still love you, Mark.
Did Steve Jobs actually sell the company to this board of directors? I mean, he was still the guy who came up with the idea, so therefore it would be his company. I mean, maybe I'm missing something here.
Well, you're in the area of intellectual property at this point.
No, actually, that's not under the purview of intellectual property. That's under the purview of a management of a company. And what I'm looking at this totally different than how you are, Mark. I'm looking at this of, if you don't want fired from a company that you started from the ground, then don't make it a public company to where anybody can buy shares and anybody can decide who's on the board of directors and the board of directors can decide who the CEO is.
That's what
if you want to make sure that you run your company, then you keep it a private company where you own all of the company and there are no investors.
Or at the very least, you have some kind of contract that's put into place and a variety of things like that. So Ian and I have a contract that functions as a partnership agreement, and it states, you know, where we can be fired from and where we can't be fired from and those sorts of things. So that's one of the reasons why you can keep a company smaller. But if you want all that extra money that comes with taking a company public, then, well... I understand why people go for the money. They'll go for the money.
Right.
I mean, for the right amount of money, I'll sell somebody Free Talk Live and Ian and I can start all over creating a new radio show and do it all over again. At that point, well, we don't have to worry about selling ads anymore.
To answer your question, Mark, I do see where you're coming from. And I understand where Daryl's coming from too about, you know, not going public. To answer your question, the way I would go about this is I would not fire you because I feel it would be wrong. In my heart, it would be wrong because you seem like a good guy. You guys originally started Free Talk Live. The idea itself belongs to you guys. That's how
it is. Well, you're the kind of guy I want to work with, Mike, I can assure you, where I can do just about anything without getting fired. I appreciate that. 855-450-3733. You know, Steve Jobs was in many ways the goose that laid the golden egg, and Apple didn't do so well when he wasn't there. Some people will credit him with being a genius. Some people will say not so much. Your thoughts? 855-450-3733. 855-450-FREE.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
This is Sharon Hunt. Before using Heart and Body Extract, my energy level was very, very low. I could only walk a few feet and then would have to sit down. I was tired and lethargic. But after taking Heart and Body Extract, my energy level has improved greatly and I can now walk longer distances without getting tired so fast. Thank you, Heart and Body Extract.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Does being over 40 make you feel like half the man you used to be? You feel more tired, out of shape, not in the mood like you used to be? Thanks to an exclusive formula, you can help boost testosterone levels safely and naturally. Introducing Ageless Male, a life-changing supplement for men tested to help increase testosterone levels.
You'll notice a boost in your energy levels. Workouts work, sex life improves. It's like a light switch goes on.
Try Ageless Male risk-free if you would like to experience what taking Ageless Male can feel like. Support for healthy, normal testosterone levels, healthy energy, and increased performance, and more romance when you want it.
Call 1-800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Hi, my name is DeRay, suffering from migraines, having Botox injections in my head and neck to alleviate pain, costing $1,500 out of my pocket. I discovered Dr. Ortman and Gentle Touch Chiropractic Adjustment called NUCA. I'm migraine-free since my first adjustment. Thanks for giving me my life back, Dr. Ortman. I wish they prescribed you instead of Botox.
Thanks, DeRay. Putting the bones back in place is only half of the solution. We design a nutritional supplement program the body can handle, actually absorb, providing nutrients targeting the problem area. Between NUCA and nutrition, we will have you on the road to a faster and more permanent recovery. Look us up on the web at drortman.com or call 952-303-9124. Let us help you feel better faster. Wellspring Spinal Care at 952-303-9124. Again, that's 952-303-9124. Or on the web at drortman.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want on Constitution Day with Mark.
And Daryl.
Yeah. We've asked a bunch of college graduates questions about the Constitution, and they've answered. And, you know, fair to middling as far as the response goes. Not that great. I am headed out to Las Vegas October the 29th and 30th, be doing Free Talk Live out there. It's the first time we've done Free Talk Live from Las Vegas. You can join me and Trace Mayer and Dr. Stephanie Murphy, Brian Sovereign. Both of those are former co-hosts here on Free Talk Live, and many more Bitcoin enthusiasts at the Bitcoin Investor Conference. It's happening at the beautiful D Hotel in downtown Las Vegas to be distinguished from the Strip. So it's in downtown. And in Nevada, obviously. It's an event you don't want to miss because it will be a lot of fun. By the way, the D Hotel takes Bitcoin. Now, I did find out today they take Bitcoin for everything but gambling. So I don't know if it just, you know, they can't figure out how to do that or what. I'm going to find out more when I get. I'm going to find out for you. I will find out. But lots of folks are going to be there. Tone Vase, who is known for his futures predictions in Bitcoin, and Bitcoin Bell, also another co-host of Free Talk Live at one point. Paul Pui, Joseph Von Perling, should be a star-studded event. Bitcoininvestor.com. I believe you can get your early bird tickets until tomorrow or today. Bitcoininvestor.com. Go get them now. It's the best thing you can do. Bitcoininvestor.com. Let's go to the phones. Got Aaron calling in on Skype. Aaron, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hi, guys. I was thinking about liberty and why we need it. It occurs to me that there's two roads to a nonviolent society. One of them is where everybody leaves each other alone in isolation, and the other one would be where people just sort of eventually fall in line into a complete organism where if we just, if
like
the people
a bunch
didn't,
of bees.
Right. If people didn't break the laws, there would be no cause for police violence. If the we came under one world government, there'd be no reason for governments to go to war amongst each other.
That much is true. Let's see. Do you think that in a one world government situation, you wouldn't have places that wanted to sort of fight, regions that wanted to fight each other that would be, you know, sort of unwillingly under the one world government?
I mean, I guess that's why the Roman Empire fractured, but eventually it's, we've been, over time, we've been seeing less and less war, less and less fracturing like that. As the culture becomes interconnected through the internet and mass media, more and more people are willing to coexist in these groups.
I don't know if you could say that there's less and less fracturing, because there are a good many secessionist organizations that are attempting in various parts of the world to break away from one country and start another. I can think of at least half a dozen in the former Soviet Union that are attempting in one way or another to form their own governments. Some of those have been doing so violently, whether it is a war they started or a war that was started by a larger government entity trying to prevent them from seceding. But I can think right off the top of my head, there's Chechnya, there's South Ossetia, there's Transnistria, then you've got Kurdistan in Turkey, Iraq, and Syria, and each of those are fighting in various ways for independence. And there are a good many others that I can't even think of. So I don't know if I agree that there's less sectionalism.
You would say that there's less than 100 of these conflicts, perhaps, or even 1,000. Because even a couple thousand years ago, within the United States, all the fractured tribes of the Native Americans fought amongst each other constantly.
Yeah,
South
but they were,
America.
They were fighting, mostly they fought nations against nation, as opposed to sort of tribe against tribe. So they had different alliances that were within each other and those sorts
but
of things.
But there were many more nations within the United States before.
Many more,
there was
but
also
not
feudal Europe.
Yeah, feudal Europe had, I mean, the alliances weren't as powerful. But if you look at just 100 years ago, under colonialism, there were fewer than 100 nations, and now there's almost 200. Or more
in the short term. But it seems, you understand what I'm saying, though, that there's less mass conflict. There's less instances, even over the last 100 years, where millions of people are dying in these huge epic battles.
I think you could probably bring a lot of peoples around the world under a one world government if that one world government didn't do much. So if it was just sort of an organization that claimed to provide, say, military protection, then you might be able to get people to sign up. Essentially, that's what happened with the United States. The United States...
I was thinking the United Nations.
The United Nations, it just doesn't work that well with them.
Right, but you know, they are a global entity that all recognized nations, or let me rephrase that, all nations that have a modicum of recognition, meaning more than just, you know, one or two recognized countries that are recognizing them, are all members of the United Nations. There's 193 members of the UN.
Yeah, well, I guess what I'm saying here is that for instance, Belgium or Costa Rica, you know, these countries aren't spending much on military because they don't have to.
Right.
If Belgium disbands its entire military tomorrow, Costa Rica doesn't have one.
Right, and because they've got a treaty with the U.S. government that the U.S. government will be military for them.
I believe that's the same thing with Belize, too. So, I mean, there's these nations that have no military. The United States taxpayer floats their taxpayers on their back, by paying to keep the shipping lanes clear and, you know, whatever it is. And if an organization simply did that, they may be able to get enough people on board that it would then pressure other organizations. So if you say 180 nations around the world said, sure, we'll take that protection that you're offering for, you know, little to nothing, then the other 13 nations might say, well, I guess we got to kind of sign up. Otherwise, we're just on the other team against these folks. We can't, you know, pay to fight them.
I don't know if you could get 180 countries to sign up under one country providing their military. Okay. Because, no, right now you've got basically one world power and then two pseudo world powers. China and Russia are the two that I'm considering to be pseudo. And they've got a lot of influence. The government of China, since like the 1970s, has gotten a large number of countries to like remove their official diplomatic ties with Taiwan under what's called the One China Rule. So you've got people that will do whatever China says because, well, it's China.
Well, that much is true. Aaron, why don't you just go ahead, rather than trying to sell us on your premise, why don't you go ahead and state your premise? Because I don't think you're going to sell us on it.
All right. My premise is that if we had a one-world government, there wouldn't be a need for militaries because you wouldn't have any other guys. It would just be us collectively, at which point the government wouldn't have this army or this military branch of violence, and the people wouldn't see a need to vote people into power, and the people in power wouldn't see a need to create a military for no reason. And so then they would start to lose their efficacy for enforcing this fear mentality to get them to give more power, and you would reach a balance between the governed and the governors.
I think it's an interesting theory. What I would say is if there is one world government, that a certain class of people would control, and I'm talking about sort of ethnic classes or regional classes, those sorts of things. A sort of region or ethnicity would tend to be more powerful, at least perceived as more powerful. Therefore, you would have animosity from the non-powerful ethnicities, whether it was true or not, and that those ethnicities would fracture away, saying, "I can't put up with this crap. Why would we turn over military strength to these people?" I just don't. I don't think we live in the world where one world government would work.
I could see potentially a three world government.
It sounds like a work of fiction, which, you know, I mean, those sell a lot of things, so you should work on that. Thanks a lot. Appreciate the call. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180. Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about here on this live edition of Free Talk Live. It's Constitution Day with Mark.
And Daryl.
And we have been talking about, well, some questions that, constitutional-type questions were asked to college graduates and seeing how they responded and how well they did. Real quick, you can go to archives.freetalklive.com and get for free like a decade's worth of the show. All kinds of audio content there delivered to you for free. Archives.freetalklive.com.
So the president of ACTA, which is the American Council of Trustees and Alumni, says the findings are deeply troubling and underscore how our educational institutions are utterly failing to prepare our next leaders for citizenship. In a republic which depends on an educated citizenry, it's crucial that all Americans, especially college graduates, are fully familiar with the rights and responsibilities set out in the Constitution.
You know, this was sort of one of the things about the Constitution that was said early on. Benjamin Franklin supposedly said, some lady said, "Mr. Franklin, what have you brought to us? What have you brought us? A republic, madam, if you can keep it. Now, might I touch you where your petticoats go?" Right? Like, you know, those kind of things. The others is that Jefferson said is that periodically the tree of liberty must be watered with the blood of patriots and kings or tyrants.
Tyrants.
But I repeat myself. So what they're saying there is that this is an ethereal thing, that the Constitution, as they understood it, was a shot at making this work.
Right. And Jefferson
actually.
Jefferson actually had a quote that said I've heard 20 and I've heard 40 and I can't verify which one's
every
accurate.
Every generation is what I heard.
There's also that, which he did say, but he also rephrased, you know, like people quote themselves and they'll change it up a little bit. So basically every generation needs a revolution.
Yeah.
And when he said that, he wasn't just saying, you know, like, oh, we need like, you know, fresh leadership in there and term limits. No, like he literally meant like every generation you need to start over and try to, you know, go back to liberty.
And I would ask you is, who are these old dead men to have given us this government? When I think about things like Election Day being on November the 4th and the implementation of the office being on January 20th, I think to myself, man, it just sounds like a republic that was put together when people rode around on horseback. I mean, you know who the president is for weeks.
Well, the inauguration day was originally March 4th. It was moved up to January 20th.
Yeah.
And the electoral votes are not officially counted until January 6th.
Yeah, I agreed. The Electoral College really kind of throws a wrench
in. They meet
there.
In December. The Congress meets, I think it's like the first Monday of the new year, which generally somewhere between like the 3rd to the 6th. And then they count the electoral votes.
Yes, but it's laughable.
It is.
It's a, ha, 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 these old pretentious people think they're picking the president. They are, really. But people have already, in their mind, picked the president.
Right.
And those people would have the flesh picked from their bones if they decided to choose somebody besides who was on, if they hadn't died or something.
Right.
But, you know, this is, I don't know.
That's one reason I'm really hoping for either an electoral college tie to where both of the major party candidates get 269 electoral votes, which is theoretically possible.
Sure.
Or I just want somebody to not wind up getting 270 and have like a really strong third candidate that winds up getting electoral votes to see how that person does when the House of Representatives votes on who's going to be the president.
Yeah, well, that person will not do very well because the House of Representatives is populated with Democrats and Republicans. So.
Right, but again, Mark, you're thinking in a vacuum here to where if somebody winds up doing so well as to carry some electoral votes, chances are whatever group they're affiliated with is going to win some congressional seats as well.
That's a possibility.
So, you know,
so let's go on with some of these questions.
Yeah, before I do, one of the things that they found in their study, in addition to asking people questions, they were researching for a book that they wrote called What Will They Learn? They found that only 18% of American colleges and universities require students to take a course in American history, which may explain why there's some dum-dums. The first question that they asked.
I've stopped, I used to be on this path where I'm like, well, you know, everybody's got to know the Constitution. If you don't swear an oath to this thing, now if you swear an oath to this thing and you swear an oath to something you haven't read before, well, your oath isn't worth crap.
Right.
Your word isn't worth crap. And you know, I'd be like, I don't care anything about your oath. Your oath is meaningless to me. It is disgusting to me. It's dirt. But if you are just your average American, why should you know the Constitution?
I don't know necessarily if the average person should know like every word and whatnot of the Constitution, but they should know how the government works so that they know that they're being screwed over when things aren't being done properly.
I think they know that already.
Most people don't know that they're being screwed over.
Well,
they think politicians, they're doing it, so it must be legal.
Politician is synonymous with liar and thief. And so I think that people generally believe that.
Question number one, which of the following serves on the U.S. Supreme Court? Elena Kagan, Lawrence Warren Pierce, Judith Scheinlin, or John Kerry?
None of those. One of those?
You are incorrect.
Okay.
Elena Kagan.
Okay, yeah, I don't know.
She is the most recent Supreme Court person.
All right.
It was either her or Sonia Sotomayor that was most recent.
I missed it. Right, Sotomayor I recognize, but I didn't
Lawrence know. Warren Pierce is a name I had never heard, so I did a Google search for him. He's a guy that got arrested for like pedophilia and kidnapping.
It's funny.
Yeah.
It's got a nice name, though.
Question number two, a trial of impeachment of a U.S. president takes place before the U.S. Senate, the U.S. Supreme Court, the U.S. House of Representatives, or the District Court of Columbia's Court of Appeals?
Representatives.
That is correct. And only 25% knew that. 49% thought it was the Senate. 24% thought it was the Supreme Court. 1% thought it was the D.C. Court of Appeals.
Okay.
What is the Bill of Rights? A signed petition upon which the U.S. Constitution was based, a name given to a group of constitutional amendments, the law among the states prior to the ratification of the U.S. Constitution, or a list of demands sent to the British monarchy by the colonial Americans.
I can name each one of what those things are, but yeah, it's a list of amendments. It's 10, yes. The first 10.
23% thought it was a petition upon which the U.S. Constitution was based. 7% thought that it was...
Which would have been the Declaration of Independence. That's a petition.
Kind of a petition, but it wasn't a petition made to create the U.S. Constitution.
No. The Declaration, the Constitution was based on the Declaration in a very vague sense, I suppose.
And in a very vague sense, it was an amendment to the Articles of Confederation.
That's what it was supposed to be.
Yes.
That's what they were convened for.
The Articles of Confederation, by the way, was the law in the states prior to the ratification of the U.S. Constitution. 7% of the people surveyed thought that's what the Bill of Rights was. I did not ask this. Which of the following is not granted to the executive branch by the Constitution? Establishing taxes, nominating the Supreme Court justices, granting pardons, or acting as commander-in-chief of the military?
What was it? Taxes, right?
Yes. 80% got that one right.
Oh, excellent.
So, you know, not completely dumb.
These are college graduates. These are not the average person. And I don't know why particularly they chose to do college graduates in this circumstance, because it's, you know, voting isn't limited to college graduates.
Right. But I think it was more because they were also trying to find out what college students are learning. And they found that only 18% of colleges and universities require either an American history or an American government class for graduation.
I see.
Skipping down, who was the father of the Constitution? George Mason, Thomas Jefferson, Ben Franklin, or James Madison?
Well, this one's kind of tough because we're told so much about Franklin and Jefferson, but it turns out it was Madison, who was quite an intellectual heavyweight.
Yes.
For being such a little shorty guy. Anyway, cute. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. To the surprise of some, the Federal Reserve refused to raise interest rates at its meeting today. Federal Reserve Board Chair Janet Yellen says there's still a lot of slack in the U.S. labor market despite falling unemployment rates.
Very high levels of part-time, involuntary employment and labor force participation that suggests that at least to some extent the standard unemployment rate understates the degree of slack in the labor market.
Low inflation, weak oil prices, and signs of a slowdown in China also kept the rate low. Yellen does say rates could be edged upward later this year. For the third time, Senate Republicans failed to force a vote on the Iran nuclear deal.
Virtually guaranteeing a win for the president, the Senate also rejecting a move to link the lifting of sanctions to Iran's recognition of Israel and the release of four Americans. Even though he opposes the overall agreement, Arizona Republican Jeff Flake said he would reject the conditions.
Not that I don't want hostages released or Israel recognized, but the entire agreement should not be based on those two items. There are other important aspects of the agreement.
Majority Leader Mitch McConnell predicting the agreement will be reviewed by the next president, but adding its negative consequences will live on.
Correspondent Wally Hines reporting. A hearing has begun to determine if Sergeant Bo Bergdahl should face a military trial for leaving his post in Afghanistan in June of 2009. Army Forces Command spokesman Colonel Daniel King says Bergdahl faces two charges.
Article 85. Desertion with intent to shirk important or hazardous duty, and one count of Article 99, misbehavior before the enemy by endangering the safety of a command, unit, or place.
Bergdahl was traded for six Taliban commanders by the Obama administration. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 65 points. More on these stories at townhall.com.
There are times when people need a little extra money, honest, hardworking people, and some banks don't always make it fast or easy. But finally, there's a company who gets it who could help my listeners that need it. Avant. You simply go to avantoffer.com on your computer or phone to check your rate risk-free with no effect on your FICO score. Complete your application in minutes and the funds could be in your account as soon as tomorrow. If any of my listeners need a loan between $1,000 and $35,000, go to avantoffer.com. Avant will give you a $50 Amazon.com gift card after you make your first payment on time. For this offer and to check your rate risk-free, go to avantoffer.com and enter promo code BORROW. That's AVANTOffer.com, promo code BORROW, avantoffer.com, promo code BORROW. Loans made by WebBank and by affiliates Avant Incorporated. California loans offered by Avant are made under Finance Lenders License Number 603K124. Funds are generally deposited via ACH for delivery next business day if approved by 4:30 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday. Amazon is not a sponsor of this promotion. Other restrictions apply. See website for details.
Scientists say a cup of coffee in the evening may be keeping you awake for more reasons than you realize.
We've all reached for something caffeinated to keep us awake. But a team at the UK's Medical Research Council and the University of Colorado found it has a more profound effect too. Inside every cell in your body is a chemical clock keeping time. Experiments on people locked in a sleep laboratory for 50 days showed a double espresso before bed could set the body clock back 40 minutes, and it delayed the production of the sleep hormone melatonin. The powerful role caffeine plays on the body clock could be used in treating sleep disorders and even for tackling jet lag.
That's BBC correspondent James Gallagher reporting. Seismologists are crediting Chile's heavy investment in tsunami alerts and structural reinforcement for limiting the death and destruction from yesterday's 8.3 magnitude earthquake. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. President Obama met today with the three young Americans who thwarted an attack last month upon a passenger train headed to Paris. Mr. Obama expressed his gratitude for their extraordinary bravery. The three subdued a man with ties to radical Islam who boarded the train with a Kalashnikov, a pistol, and a box cutter. President Obama says the story of their heroic actions is incredible.
They were just going to have a fun reunion up in Paris and ended up engaging a potential catastrophic situation.
Air Force Airman First Class Spencer Stone says visiting the Oval Office was insane.
It was pretty surreal. Another surreal event to just add to this past crazy month.
Stone was joined by pals Anthony Sadler and Alex Skarlatos at the reception in the White House. Stone was awarded the Purple Heart. More on these stories at townhall.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about here on Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls. It's Mark with you.
And Daryl.
Yep. And, you know, I've been hearing about this fella, Jeremy Corbyn. Daryl, you familiar with him?
I wasn't until about an hour and a half ago.
Okay, well, what he is he's been a member of parliament over in Great Britain since like dinosaurs roamed the earth. I mean, he's been there a long time. And he is, he's just recently been named the head of Labour and therefore the opposition coalition. Is that right?
Well, just because you're the head of Labour does not necessarily make you the opposition leader when Labour's in the minority. So because the British House of Commons has several parties represented, you
have proportional representation there as opposed to...
No, they don't.
They don't? Okay.
They do not. They have what are essentially congressional districts.
Okay.
I don't think they call them ridings. That's what they call them in Canada. But, you know, they have districts, and it's first past the post. So whoever gets a plurality of the vote winds up winning that district. But they have fair ballot access to where every party, even the monster raving loony party, has the same procedure for getting its candidate on the ballot that the Labour or Conservatives have.
I want to ask you more about that a little later because I think you know a lot about this kind of thing.
Right. So let me finish explaining about the opposition.
Yeah.
So you don't necessarily have one party that has a majority of the seats. So a lot of times you will hear, or they will have what you hear called a minority government, meaning that it's a party that is in coalition with other parties to wind up having over a majority of seats to form the coalition government. And so then that would be the majority or the government.
They put together two minorities to make a majority.
Right. Yes. So there's that, and then the opposition is basically the affiliation of all of the other groups. In theory, you could have a couple oppositions. So you could have some people that say, no, we're not joining you in opposition to the majority. We're dissenting. So the opposition is not just one party. It's generally a conglomeration of a couple of parties. And the largest of the minority parties in the opposition will generally head up the opposition.
Right. So at this point, there's the folks that disagree with the majority are essentially the opposition.
Yes.
Okay. And the guy who represents the opposition in this circumstance is Jeremy Corbyn.
Yes.
And he probably will for a couple of years. And Jeremy Corbyn is the leader of the Labour Party, which is kind of like the middle left party in Great Britain. And Jeremy's not quite as middle left as the rest of these folks. He's an avowed socialist. And he's got himself a beard.
And also a Republican.
Well, yes, a Republican means something entirely different.
I know. I just wanted to make sure I could say that right after you called him a socialist because I wanted to make some heads explode.
Jeremy Corbyn is a Republican, and a socialist. Yes, that's right.
Yes, he supports a Republican form of government, meaning no monarch. He wants a president and something more akin to what the U.S. has as he far wants as a government.
Well, I don't know if he wants – who knows what he wants precisely. He wants a republic as opposed to a monarchy, and that is really integral to this particular story. So there's all kinds of upset going on in Great Britain about this. I've heard about it on the news and that sort of thing. And actually, I've had some folks, our foreign correspondents over there, talking to us about it. And I guess there was, over the weekend, they had something like their Remembrance Day or, the equivalent of Memorial Day or something like that. And he shows up. It's on a Sunday. It's called Remembrance Sunday. He shows up and he does the things that everybody else is doing. He stands there. He's, standing amongst people who are wearing far too much gold stuff and that kind of thing. Now, there's a moment when they sing the national anthem, and he stands. Now, he's standing. His shirt isn't buttoned up all the way. He doesn't have his tie done all the way. Remember, this guy's been doing this MP thing for a long time, a member of parliament, and he's a socialist. He doesn't really take all the pomp and circumstance very seriously. So, whatever. He doesn't have his tie buttoned all the way up, the top collar buttoned, and he doesn't have his jacket buttoned. I was taught if you stand, your jacket's buttoned every time. He doesn't have that either. But I don't think that's as crucial as other things. So people are upset that he doesn't look as smart as he should, and they're upset that he's not singing the national anthem. Now, in the United States, this would be political suicide. If a politician shows up someplace at Memorial Day or whatever and doesn't sing the national anthem or doesn't do, at least what the next politician next to him is doing, that level of it. This is why you have them when the national anthem comes on at the presidential debates. All of them will put their hands over their heart.
Yes.
You don't put your hand over your heart for the national anthem. Whoever started this, it is not the Pledge of Allegiance, it's the national anthem. You stand and remove your hat, and you put your hands behind your back if you have to have something to do with them. But somebody, some uninformed jackhole, put their hand over their heart, then everybody's also like, oh, I guess I better put my hand over my heart. If I'm ever up there, I'm going to lift my left leg too, and then just see if they all do it. Because, it's just a monkey-see-monkey-do situation.
Yes.
But I think that this is more forgivable when Jeremy Corbyn does it than if, say, Bernie Sanders did it. Now, Bernie Sanders, you can relate Corbyn and Sanders in many ways. They have probably a lot of the same ideas, it would be my guess. So if Sanders chooses not to sing the national anthem, I suspect he's going to take at least a few points in the polls. They're going to suddenly say he's no longer electable, as though he was electable in the first place. The guy's going to be 6 years older than Reagan, our oldest president, if he decides to take office. And I see no evidence that he's a particularly healthy individual. But, Ron Paul would have been certainly old, but healthier in 2008. And
right.
Obviously, he's still alive, right? He's alive now. Ron Paul would have made it all the way through if he would have made it in 2008. And probably would have made it all the way through if he made it in 2012, too. But, obviously they could pick a better, a good running mate for him or whatever. I don't think that the age particularly matters, but I do think it matters in sort of the realm of electability. But I think that if he didn't sing the national anthem, it would be a real problem. However, when it comes to Jeremy Corbyn, the national anthem in Great Britain is God Save the Queen. So what you're asking is somebody who doesn't believe that there should be a monarchy is to sing a song extolling the monarchy, and if they don't do it, they're a bad patriot. This is what people are doing. They're questioning, how could you possibly besmirch the name of our brave men and women who fought against Hitler, Hitler, sir. They're so upset they don't know what to do with themselves. They're spitting mad that a person who doesn't believe in a monarchy didn't sing a song extolling a monarch because it's bad for the soldiers. Well, I don't get this. I think it's just lame. I hate the partisanship when one party just seems to pound on a particular issue and it's all about party, 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 and I don't have any, you know, it's not going to forward the conversation anyway.
It reminds me of the comic or the political cartoon, if you will, of the boy sitting down in the classroom during the Pledge of Allegiance.
Yeah.
And the teacher bringing in this veteran in a wheelchair and says, "This man can't stand, so little Timmy, you should, because, you know, something, something troops died for your right to not stand."
Right.
It's like, wait a second. So if I have the right to not stand, why are you, you know, belittling me for not standing if it is my right?
Oh, and I would say that, you know, hey, since Corbyn's an anti-war guy, maybe, you know, a lot of the amputees from the, you know, anti-war people wouldn't have sent these folks over to fight and get injured in the first place.
Right.
So, you know, it's the anti-war activists that want soldiers to walk. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733.
I have a 70-pound Royal Standard Poodle. Her name is Zelia. And 3 years ago, Zelia's ears were a mess. She would have sticky, gooey, smelly discharge in her ears. We took Zelia to the vet 7 times of $150 every time. The vet offered no success at all. My wife and I are driving, and we hear some people on the radio saying D-I-N-O-V-I-T-E.
859-428-1000. The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
6 days after I started feeding her Dinovite, my dog's ear problems were cured. My dog no longer yelps. She can be petted without pain, and it's because Dinovite made our dog healthy again.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com. Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't take on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Ricky LeBlanc, admitted in Mass only. Sokolov Law, LLC, Chestnut Hill, Mass. Ken Levin, responsible attorney in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Greg Hobby, New Jersey. The choice of lawyer is an important decision that should not be based solely upon advertisements. While this firm maintains joint responsibility, most cases of this type are referred to other attorneys for principal responsibility. If you know what mesothelioma is, you or someone you love has likely been impacted by this devastating cancer. You may be entitled to compensation. Call Sokolov Law today. 1-800-218-HELP. The only known cause of mesothelioma is asbestos exposure. Thousands of hardworking men and women, including many U.S. veterans and industrial workers, have been diagnosed with mesothelioma because manufacturers knew the dangers but put profits ahead of people. An estimated $30 billion in court-ordered trusts has been set aside to pay money to asbestos victims. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call now. You may be entitled to receive compensation without ever going to court or filing a lawsuit. Call for a free legal consultation at 1-800-218-HELP. That's 1-800-218-HELP.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Live 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. That's the telephone number. The question I've got is this Jeremy Corbyn character. He's a socialist over in Europe. He's the leader of the opposition, and apparently he didn't have his button buttoned when the national anthem was playing, and for the poor soldier, the fallen soldiers of World War II, or whatever the case may be. I think that this is much ado about nothing in this circumstance, and I don't usually bring it up, but this bring up stuff that's going on in, say, Great Britain or whatever, but this has really gotten across the pond because they're questioning this guy's patriotism or his commitment to his to the country, that kind of thing, and it doesn't seem like there's any issue of his commitment. I don't know what patriotism is. I think that that's just a word. It's defined different ways for different people. But nonetheless, that's what's happening over there. I'm going to tell you real quick how to save 20, 25, even more percent on items that you need for life. Basically everything you need for life. You can go through saveatpurse.com. Now, you're going to have to buy with Bitcoin. That's the catch here. You're going to have to get some Bitcoin, and I'll tell you how to do that at a relatively low rate. But if you go through saveatpurse.com, you can get items through Amazon, and you're going to have to wait just a little longer, a day or two, or sometimes a week, depending on how big of a discount you want to get. But you can use Bitcoin to buy pretty much everything at Amazon. So it's a really great deal for you. I've given you basically a big old raise, and it's going to change your life if you choose to employ it. We're employing it now at my house, and it's making a difference. Saveatpurse.com.
So two questions. What's the largest discount you've received, and how long have you had to wait?
I think we were only at like 25% and a few days.
I've gotten 30%, and I only had to wait maybe a day and a half.
Impressive. Well, nonetheless, saveitpurse.com. So Jeremy Corbyn, he's a variety of things, and he's an anti-war activist, and he shows up at Remembrance Day Sunday. He stands when the God Save the Queen is played. He doesn't have his top button buttoned. He's not smart enough, as it were. And he also doesn't sing the song, which everybody else does. Well, he doesn't want a king or queen or a monarch, so why would he sing God Save the Queen? It's silly to go after him for this.
Yeah, it really is. It would be akin to getting upset at you or I for refusing to say the Pledge of Allegiance to the Stars and Stripes.
But it's a bigger deal with saying the Pledge of Allegiance than this circumstance because, you're talking about a guy who it's unreasonable to say in the 21st century, you know what we need? We need a king. And so that's an unreasonable statement. And to sing a song about, hey, let's keep our king would be an unreasonable thing to sing.
Right. I'm just trying to bring it to something that our listeners can relate to. And yeah, they relate to, at certain events, there's a Pledge of Allegiance.
There certainly is a Pledge of Allegiance, but I don't think there's even anything to relate this to here in the United States. This is an unrelatable thing.
Well, the way I'm looking at this to where I see it as relatable is, at least I don't want to speak for you, Mark, but at least I do not want the U.S. federal government to exist. This man does not want the British monarch to continue being the British monarch. He wants a republic. So he wants a different form of government. I want a different form of government. In Great Britain, they sing God Save the Queen, and he refuses to sing. Here in the U.S., people say the Pledge of Allegiance that says indivisible liberty, justice, forever and ever, amen, and I don't say that. And I get, you know, like I cause some people to get upset when they see me either remaining seated or turning my back.
Yeah, I don't say the Pledge of Allegiance either, but the reason I don't do it is...
You've got the Quaker card.
I do have the Quaker card, but I mean, you know, that's not particularly the reason I don't. I just don't do it because I don't pledge allegiance. I am all about expedience. If another government comes along that provides more human freedom more expeditiously and you know, brings people upward into you know, evolution to something new, I'm on board with that government, and I will say goodbye, USA. You know, like that doesn't—it's not meaningful to me in that way.
Certainly, a tear
has snaked down my eye at you know, watching F-18s fly over football games and things like that. I'm not so un-American as to feel that way, but I'm just all about what's expeditious. So I'll say, hey, yay, United States government, as long as you know it continues to move towards more freedom. Sadly, it is not. It is continues to slip down the charts of freedom, and currently rated the 20th freest state on the human freedom chart put out by the Cato Institute. Not exactly a liberal organization there.
Right. Well, it was actually the Cato Institute in conjunction with Simon Fraser University, and I think it was a German school as well that came up with that rating.
But it's true. So, I mean, it was done in conjunction. Nonetheless, I think that there's some parallels to this, but the people trying to make the parallels are falling short in this because of the Republican aspect of, and by Jeremy Corbyn, this English person who is a Republican, which means something different for them.
Right.
So I want to talk real quick about the idea of getting rid of the monarchy, because I don't think it's a good idea.
Okay, well, let me first explain why I mentioned the Quaker card. I didn't mention it because, like, that's the only reason you don't say the pledge, but at least as a Quaker, you can play that card if somebody ever questions, you know, like, why aren't you saying that? I'm a Quaker. Oh, that's okay. Like, you know, it's forgivable because you're a Quaker.
They've beaten the butts. People have beaten the butts of Jehovah's Witnesses and Amish in certain circumstances like this. I don't expect the fact that I'm a Quaker to matter to a person who's willing to use violence against somebody in a circumstance like
right.
that.
Right. I'm not saying every person's going to look at that as an excuse, but most informed people know that Quakers do not take oaths. They do not pledge loyalty to anything. They will not, you know, like, swear an oath under whatever. That's why a lot of oaths are, you know, or affirm. And yeah. I affirm that I'm telling the truth.
Yeah. Here's a surprise. I'm telling you the truth. If I'm speaking, I'm telling you the truth. So in this circumstance, what we're talking about with a Republican is a person who wants to set up a government that doesn't have a king or a queen. And what I've got to kind of wonder now, the king or queen in Great Britain gets paid, the queen gets a lot of money from the government. But I think she brings in a lot of money too. She's a tourist attraction, as are all of her trappings. And so when you're talking about the palace, you've got all these fellas standing out with those silly hats and all that stuff in the sun. People come out to see them marching around and to see the palace. There's several palaces. People want to see all these things that have to do with the monarchy and all this stuff. So I don't know, and I don't think that it's difficult to figure out how much money she brings in.
Let's play point counterpoint.
Okay. Let's do that. 855 do you think England should get rid of its monarchy? 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
I am a 47-year-old female and had a heart attack in 2005. This is Alice from New Jersey. I still get angina, even with four stents. I was taking Nitro two or three times a week. The very first day after taking Heart and Body Extract, the chest pain was gone. Now I don't wear a Nitro patch.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Ready Supply Foods sells more food for your money than any other company, and we can prove it. We've gathered nutritional facts from our competitors' own websites and divided them by price to show you how much they sell per dollar. In an emergency, calories mean survival. Ready Supply Foods sells 245 calories per dollar, where the others average only 155. That's 58% more for your money. We're the new leader in value and quality. See the comparisons at ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
This is a healthcare alert from the Pain Relief Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You don't have to suffer any longer. You can immediately qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you by calling our 24/7 Pain Relief Hotline at 866-389-0620. Delivery is free and all paperwork is handled for you. If you are on Medicare and have knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain, don't wait. You can qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost by calling our 24/7 pain hotline now at 866-389-0620. Our representatives are standing by 24/7 to take your call and rush you your pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you. Shipping is free and all paperwork is handled for you. Just call 866-389-0620. That's 866-389-0620. Again, 866-389-0620.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Many are in disbelief today after word of shocking allegations against a Minnesota-based talk syndication company known as GCN. It's claimed that they're the fourth largest talk syndication company in the U.S., making it even more scandalous that they've been accused of helping business owners expose themselves on a massive scale. Let's go live to Tom for more on this story.
It's being called the greatest exposure of our lifetime, while other business owners are beginning to step forward claiming they, too, exposed themselves with the help of GCN.
It's true. They're all guilty. Every last one of them. GCN helped me get the exposure my company needed, and just think, that was years ago. Today, GCN has like 700 affiliate stations and over 6 million downloads from iTunes and their website every month.
Imagine the exposure your company can get. Expose your business to the masses. Email advertise at gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective. GCN.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. We're talking about Jeremy Corbyn. This is the leader of the opposition party in Great Britain. Not that I know a lot about this, but apparently there's all kinds of upset surrounding him not having his top button buttoned and not singing God Save the Queen, and basically not being sufficiently servile bowing and scraping at Remembrance Sunday for the Battle of Britain.
One thing I will say is if you're wearing a tie and you don't have the top button buttoned, you look absolutely ridiculous.
Oh, I don't think so. I think that it shows that you're sort of done with whatever it is that you're doing. You can look that way sort of after work, if you know what I mean.
Right.
So I don't think it looks ridiculous.
If I walk into a bank where people are wearing ties and the teller has the tie and the top button is undone, that looks ridiculous.
Yeah, it looks like you...
I think neckties are ridiculous to begin with, but if you're going to wear it properly.
Well, I think that one can, you know, have a situation where, you know, maybe you have gotten too big for this shirt and it's choking me or something like that. It's time to get a new shirt. You can go to, you can get them for like $10 or $15 down at the Marshalls or TJ Maxx or whatever.
I don't know if they have those in Great Britain.
They've got something, and you can get a shirt that buttons. His shirt's pressed. Okay, if you have a pressed shirt, you can afford to buy another one of those pressed shirts.
If you are a member of parliament, you can afford to buy a shirt.
Yes, certainly that's the case. So the shirt fits in his case. He just didn't feel like doing the top button. And it's Sunday. Maybe he feels like that's his day to relax. So whatever. I don't really care if that's what he's chosen to do. But I'm of the opinion that it is... not particularly wise for Great Britain to get rid of its monarch, and I think you had some things you wanted to say about that, Daryl. So the point I'm making here is that...
Tourism.
Yeah, basically it's tourism. The Queen is an incredibly powerful tourist attraction in her trappings, right? The horses, the carriages, the guys with the silly Q-tip, black Q-tip hats, the whole thing that goes around the monarchy in Great Britain. People come to see that. If you and I were in Great Britain for a couple of days for some kind of radio event or whatever, Daryl, I can't imagine that we wouldn't go to some place that was not in some way, shape, or form related to the monarchy. You know, that didn't have a beefeater running around or one of these fellas with silly hats or whatever. I mean, I can't imagine we'd be able to avoid that.
Okay, so let me make a counterpoint.
So they bring in millions and millions of dollars a year.
They also bring in a lot of pounds, okay. Which is the currency they use there.
Yep.
But there are other places in Europe that used to be monarchies that still get a lot of tourist dollars because people want to go see where Louis XIV used to live.
Yeah.
There are places in the United States that have horses and buggies where people go spend a lot of money. And I'm not just talking about Amish country, Disney. Disney has horses and buggies, and your little daughter can dress up like a princess and ride the buggy and pretend that she's Snow White and the fairy dwarfs and something about Cinderella at midnight and a pumpkin. Like, all of those things happen and bring in tourist dollars.
Well, just
so you don't need an active monarch for people to want to go see palaces. You don't need an active monarch to have guys wearing funny hats. Like, you could have... the recreation of this is what happened.
It's not
and
authentic.
People are going to go. People go spend money to watch recreations of Revolutionary War battles.
They do, but if you actually had a battle, you'd be able to get more people to go because authenticity sells. And I would be willing to bet that the Louis the 16th tour or whatever at the Palace of Mirrors or whatever it is is not going to bring the revenue that the tours do in Great Britain, where they say, and the Queen was just in this room just earlier today, you know, and they take people around, they show them. I just don't think that it's going to be as big of a deal. At one point...
I'm not saying it's going to be as big, but...
That's the point, though.
They're
the
still
revenue.
Going to be tourists.
Okay.
It's going to be somewhat close. People are still going to visit the UK from the US because they speak the same language. I don't have to take a translation guide with me.
I get that there will be some people that take the tour. You can't tell me, because no one can tell me, the amount of money that will be lost, the revenue that will be lost on an annual basis, because all I'm doing is I'm
and
rating...
you can't
Wait
say that there's going to be revenue that is lost.
Oh, I can say that there will be revenue that's lost. If you do away with the ruling monarch, the most powerful and most recognizable ruling monarch in the world...
Are you saying it will be a net loss?
I don't know what a net... Okay, see, that's the issue. So I know
because
that-
right now they spend a lot of money.
We don't know how much.
Hundreds of millions of pounds.
You think it's hundreds of millions of pounds? Because I would
yes.
think it was over 100 million pounds, but I wouldn't think it was hundreds of millions.
I believe it is hundreds of millions of pounds that are spent in either direct or indirect support and payments to the royal family.
Yep.
So paying for the upkeep of all of these castles... we have to pay staff to be there in case Prince Harry decides to go there for the weekend. So, you know, you have this large expense, and then you subtract that from whatever revenue is brought in, and that would be the net. So subtract all of that from whatever revenue would be lost from, oh, we don't have a queen anymore, so, you know, we're losing 5 million pounds of tourism dollars. Are you saying it would be a net loss? Because I'm saying it would at minimum break even, if not be a net surplus.
Yeah, it says that the queen is worth $330 million. I don't know what at this point she gets paid, but, you know, I don't know what it costs for the upkeep of all these palaces and all those soldiers and all that stuff. But I can say that there will be a loss in revenue, and that if you do away with the most powerful monarch, the most recognizable monarch on the earth, and I think you agree with that, I don't know if it'll be a net loss or not, but Great Britain doesn't really have that much interesting. London, what do you want to see in London that doesn't have to do with some old monarch?
Big Ben.
Big Ben was put up by an old monarch.
Okay, and if you go to Boston, almost everything is connected to the American Revolution. So the point I'm making is there's still going to be tourist sites if there's not a monarch currently serving.
Let's go to Wayne calling in from Missouri. Wayne, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hi, yeah. That is an interesting conversation about the queen. She's not really worth a whole bunch of money as far as like on the world stage.
Yeah, she's I guess she's the
300 million. That's really not that much money, really.
Yeah, 285th on the Sunday Times rich list, but I don't know if that's England or what.
The UK Mirror says it costs taxpayers £334 million a year to cover all of the expenses associated with the monarch.
Yeah, hard to know what she brings in as far as even restaurants where people eat and things like that too. Go ahead, Wayne.
I'm going to go a little bit off the subject. This is just something I've seen. I just got out of jail today.
Well, congratulations.
well, thank you. Yeah, I got out of jail today. I got 10 days for a DWI sentence. But I witnessed an acquaintance of mine get sentenced for 10 years on a pot charge. He's 22 years old, a young kid. His first time getting arrested for this alleged pot charge.
How much and cannabis did he have?
Nothing worth that much time. They were just trying
years.
To make an example of him.
What state was it? Yeah. Missouri?
Missouri, yep.
Wow.
Missouri's also where the one guy is serving like a life sentence for having like an ounce.
I think they let that guy go, actually, at one point, finally. Wayne, is there anything more on this?
Not really. We're just waiting on, you know, things to progress. But, yeah, it was just really sad for me to see this kid go down.
No doubt. 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24-7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're discussing the British monarchy because we were talking about this Jeremy Corbyn fellow who's the leader of the opposition in Great Britain, who apparently didn't sing God Save the Queen at Remembrance Sunday for the Battle of Britain, and it's caused all kinds of trouble. And I'm taking the position that I think that...
Mark's a monarchist.
Nah, by no means. I am of the opinion that the monarch...
You called yourself king... And you support the existence of the British monarch because tourist. Yeah. You're a monarchist, sir.
I think that the British monarchy is a tourist draw. And I simply say I am king, but, you know, it doesn't cost anybody anything when I say that. So anyway, I told you I was going to tell you how to get some bitcoins and pay a low fee. ExpressCoin.com. I just did business with them this week. And again, another happy customer. You go to ExpressCoin.com and you can get Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin, Dashcoin, a whole variety of different coins over there. They make it fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. Completely legal. This is, you're safe. They're doing their licensed money services business. When I've done a what I consider to be a very large transaction with them, and know somebody who did a transaction to be triple that size. They bought a house with the money that they transferred through ExpressCoin.com. So Yes, I do trust ExpressCoin. I trust them explicitly. Go to ExpressCoin.com and use coupon code FTL, and you can get up to $40 worth of whatever cryptocurrency you choose with no fee at all. They already have great fees, but if you use coupon code FTL, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you'll get no fee at all if it's less than $40 worth. So it's a good way to try it out and see whether they work for you. ExpressCoin.com.
So since I was trying to figure out how much the British monarch cost the taxpayers of Great Britain, the UK Mirror has a report saying that it costs £334 million per year, and that's in addition to the $37.9 million that the Queen receives of a sovereign grant from the Treasury.
Yep.
So you add in the security, the upkeep. They've got to pay groundskeepers to keep the lawn manicured everywhere.
They do that at every museum.
The guards, all of this other stuff. But most museums, Mark, are privately funded for the vast majority of their funding.
That may or may not be true, but
the average museum in the U.S. receives as little as 25% of their funding from taxpayers through various means.
The average museum in the U.S. doesn't draw nearly as many people as the royal palaces do.
I'm not saying that they do.
I'm not saying that they couldn't do this privately, but if I was the King of England and people come to stand outside my house and they haven't been giving me any money, get out of here. You know what? Get all of you, get out of here. I go out dancing completely naked. Get out of here.
And you would
you
be deposed
stinking crazy
for
people.
Being a loony.
Well, all I'm saying is these people have no business outside somebody's house looking in their windows and seeing what goes on there if they're not paying.
I'm not saying they have any right to stand and be a peeping Tom. But what I'm saying is if you get rid of the British monarch, that people are still going to go look at palaces, and people are still going to go look at historical things.
Some people will, but not as many people. It says in the same UK Mirror article you're talking about that the Queen is a $12.5 million net benefit to the British people, and that she they don't even figure in the incredible amount of money that must come from Americans and other people that come there to see all this stuff. They're like staying in hotels and buying lunch and dinner and breakfast and all these things.
So you subtract off the $334 million a year that's being spent for the royal family. Is it revenue negative or revenue neutral for you still have people going to look at stuff? And I say it would be at minimum revenue neutral.
I don't think it'll be revenue neutral. You're talking about the most recognizable. When somebody says, think of the Queen, the most recognizable monarch. If you say think of the king, who are people thinking of? I have no clue who they think of. They just think of somebody with a crown. If they say think of the queen, they think of Queen Elizabeth. That's what I think of. I don't know. There may be people listening.
If somebody
right
tells
now,
me think of the queen, I think Buckingham Palace.
Yeah, Buckingham Palace. That's fine. So you thought of the queen's residence. And I got to say, I think that it's well worth keeping them. I'm not advocating for them to have any particular power. And they don't. They don't employ it. This woman has had the power to shoot down whatever laws she wants. And as far as I know, she's never employed that power. And if she has, she's employed it incredibly judiciously. That says to me that she is highly qualified to be in this position.
So aside from tourism, what is reason number two to keep the monarch?
I don't see another reason. It's about revenue, man. You're talking to a businessman, and all I care about is the money. So, yes, I mean, it's worth them to keep it for the money. If you had something in your front yard that drew a bunch of people in there that put money in a little box for you, you'd keep that thing in your front yard, wouldn't you? Because you'd be a fool to get rid of it. I don't care if it costs a little bit to upkeep it. You're revenue positive in keeping that thing. So keep it.
But there are things other than money that should come into account when you're making decisions about how people are being governed in their life.
You're not making a decision about how they're being governed, though. You're only making it's hardly an issue at all. Can you tell, if you can't tell me, somebody can tell me at 855-450-3733 the last time that the British monarch got, you know, in some way, shape, or form involved in government and actually stopped some law from going through or something like that. Because that would be an important issue. But I suspect if it happened, it hasn't happened very often in the past 5 decades.
Right. But one of the things that this Jeremy Corbyn guy is advocating, in addition to get rid of the monarch, is devolution, which is essentially more local control.
I'm for that. I think local control tends to be a better thing. But your local tyrants aren't that great. I mean, you live in Keene, New Hampshire. How you like your local government, buddy?
I don't like
it's
it. I wish it would
cesspool.
Go away.
Yeah, right. So, I mean, if these people had...
I wish all coercive governments all around the world would go away.
Now, Concord, in the state of New Hampshire, the state, it's a small state, has more power than, say, the local governments. The state can tell the local governments what to do. That's not
right.
Always...
New Hampshire largely does not have home rule.
Right. So, do you think that you would live in a better place or a worse place, when I'm talking about Keene, New Hampshire, if this was a home rule state?
If Keene had home rule, Keene would be about 500 to 700 times more tyrannical than it is.
Yeah.
Property taxes would be a lot higher, and they've almost doubled in the last 30 years.
So that's what I'm saying is that local control isn't always good control, is the one
right,
thing.
Right, and I'm not saying that it is always better, but I would prefer the decisions be made at a more local area than, you know, somebody far away. And if for some weird reason New Hampshire would get home rule, hopefully you would be able to convince Ian to move the show to Limpster, which is about 15 miles up the road and is the southernmost town without zoning.
Yeah, I don't know that zoning's the only thing that I would pick.
It's not the only thing, but, you know, like, zoning is definitely one of the things that has caused the city of Keene to give Ian a lot of trouble.
Well, that's...
You had a couch on the side of your house, and you can't do that because zoning.
Yeah, well, they certainly... He'd spend a little time in jail over that.
Your
one.
Friend was parking an RV in your driveway, and you can't do that because zoning.
Yes, zoning gives them a great deal of power. But in New Hampshire, you know, you never know what the tax rate is. I don't know what the tax rate is in Limpster, but it may very well be lower, maybe higher than my town. So I don't know the answer to that. You know, Ian picked the highest tax rate in the state, and
yes,
he reaps the rewards of that.
Yeah, technically, Berlin has a higher rate as far as what they charge the people, but the property values are a lot lower. So the tax that is actually paid is lower in Berlin.
Yes, it's absolutely true. So there you go. I guess this Jeremy Corbyn fella, can I say I support a socialist? I don't. But I see a lot of ado about nothing in this story about Jeremy Corbyn's buttons.
By comparison, the president of the United States and the first family cost $1.4 billion to U.S. taxpayers.
They cost a lot more than the monarchy does.
Yes.
That much is true.
And we should get rid of the president.
855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Want gold but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault, providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the Sacro Wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The fight to defund Planned Parenthood is coming to the House.
A move to block federal funding while Congress looks into those videos involving tissue research. North Carolina's Virginia Fox.
Republicans will continue to bring the truth to Americans and prevent taxpayer dollars from going to organizations that dismember children.
What are you thinking?
Massachusetts Democrat Jim McGovern says it's not about abortion.
More than 90% of what Planned Parenthood does nationally is preventive care.
The government says community health centers would be unable to pick up the slack if Planned Parenthood loses funding.
Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. Interest rates are staying where they are, but the head of the Federal Reserve says a rate hike is still likely this year. Fed Chair Janet Yellen says weakness in the international economy pushed it to hold off on raising interest rates.
In light of the heightened uncertainties abroad, and a slightly softer expected path for inflation, the committee judged it appropriate to wait for more evidence.
Some analysts say holding the rate could lift home sales and construction. The Fed could revisit the rate in its next meeting. A hearing's begun in Fort Sam Houston, Texas, to determine if Sergeant Bo Bergdahl should face a court-martial. Army Forces Command spokesman Colonel Daniel King says the purpose of the hearing is to determine if there is probable cause to put Bergdahl on trial for the two charges he's facing for leaving his post.
Bergdahl disappeared June 30, 2009, from combat outpost Mess Lalak in Paktika Province, Afghanistan, and was subsequently captured.
He faces charges of desertion and misbehavior toward the enemy. Bergdahl was exchanged by the Obama administration for five Taliban commanders held by the U.S. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 65 points. More on these stories at townhall.com.
There are times when people need a little extra money, honest, hardworking people, and some banks don't always make it fast or easy. But finally, there's a company who gets it, who could help my listeners that need it, Avant. You simply go to avantoffer.com on your computer or phone to check your rate risk-free with no effect on your FICO score. Complete your application in minutes and the funds could be in your account as soon as tomorrow. If any of my listeners need a loan between $1,000 and $35,000, go to avantoffer.com. Avant will give you a $50 Amazon.com gift card after you make your first payment on time. For this offer and to check your rate risk-free, go to avantoffer.com and enter promo code BORROW. That's A-V-A-N-T-Offer.com, promo code BORROW, avantoffer.com, promo code BORROW. Loans made by WebBank and by affiliates of Avant Incorporated. California loans offered by Avant are made under finance lender's license number 603-K124. Funds are generally deposited via ACH for delivery next business day. If approved by 4:30 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday. Amazon is not a sponsor of this promotion. Other restrictions apply. See website for details.
President Obama honored the three men who thwarted a terrorist attack on a train heading from Amsterdam to France at the White House today. The president praised the three men, Alex Skarlatos, Airman First Class Spencer Stone, and Anthony Sadler, for their teamwork, courage, and quick-thinking actions that averted a real calamity. Spencer Stone and college student Anthony Sadler were asked what it was like to meet President Obama.
Insane.
It's pretty surreal. We stood in the Oval Office today. Never thought I'd see the inside of that.
There was a moment in time where I just froze right when I walked in and saw him.
President Obama celebrated them as three friends who had been headed for a fun reunion in Paris when they ended up engaging a potentially catastrophic situation and pinning down someone who is clearly intent on doing a lot of harm to a lot of people, inflicting terror on the French. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. With Hungary's border firmly shut, more and more refugees and migrants are getting on buses and into taxis and heading towards the country of Croatia.
Once they get inside Croatia, they're in a country which has said they are welcoming, they're prepared to accept thousands, but tens of thousands will be a problem, and even a greater problem if they have no way out, because at the next border, the Slovenian crossing, the Slovenian prime minister has already made it clear he's bringing the shutters down until there is a European solution. And there's no sign of that. So thousands, possibly tens of thousands, could be stuck in Croatia.
That is BBC correspondent Lise Doucette reporting from the Serbia-Croatia border. Some 9,000 people had little choice after Hungary erected a barbed wire fence and took other measures to stop them from using it as a gateway. Others have been trying to cross by way of neighboring Slovenia. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
Call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. We've been all over the board this evening, as usual here on Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you, by the way.
And Daryl.
It's Constitution Day, so we've discussed that. We also talked about Jeremy Corbyn's buttons. This is the opposition leader in Great Britain and all the upset about him not having his shirt buttoned properly and not singing the national anthem on Remembrance Day.
I think the people were more upset about the latter of those two than the button not being buttoned.
I think they're upset because it benefits them to be upset.
Yes.
In the world of politics, people attempt to... This Benghazi thing always seemed like that for me. It's not that I think Hillary Clinton is a good politician. I do not. It just seems like somebody's always really, really, really into the whole Republicans are better than Democrats thing when they bring up Benghazi. It just seemed like a scandal. They couldn't quite get the wheels up, get it moving. So anyway, you can comment on any of those things or whatever you wish here at 855-450-3733. But a listener sent me an article that I got excited about, excited in sort of a negative way, and I think it's worth bringing up.
Excited in a negative way? Wouldn't right. that be like depressed?
Agitated?
Yes, agitated. Flustered.
Yeah. Well, excited. Excited is excited. Well, it isn't necessarily a positive thing. Usually, it's used that way though.
Yes. Yes, it is.
So, what this is that. It's on cryonics. So for those of you who listen to the show, you know that I have contracted with Alcor, ALCOR.org, to have my head lopped off and frozen in nitrogen upon my death if for whatever reason life extension doesn't occur before that.
What are you hoping they will be able to do with your severed head?
I don't know. What do you think? What are you afraid that they might be able to do with my severed head?
All I think they will be able to do with your severed head is drop it in some liquid nitrogen and laugh because they can't do anything with your head later. That's why I'm asking you, what are you hoping they can do?
Do they have, you know, there's, for instance, they find frozen people and preserved people all the time, right?
Yes.
In the future, do you think that they will want people from the past who are preserved?
So you're saying you want them to reanimate you?
I would love to be reanimated. However, I don't know if that is a reasonable expectation or not.
I don't think it is, especially if they're chopping off your head that's not connected to your body.
They'll have robot bodies. Look, they've already got robot bodies.
Yeah, I've seen Futurama. That's how
Forget
Richard
Futurama.
Nixon's head gets elected president in the year 3000.
I don't care anything about your cartoon watching
because,
habits.
No,
wait
because
a second,
it's his head. He's got a shiny new robot body. That's how he's able to get elected
Futurama
for a third term.
Like 3000 or something.
Yes.
Yeah. This is right now. They have people having prosthetics
yes.
that they can move with their brains.
Yes, and that's different than having a robot body.
It is slightly different than having a robot body. What I'm telling you, however, is that if you can go to a lab right now and you can move a prosthetic arm and pick things up, that we are only years, a few short years away from having two arms, and then a few short years away from having two arms and two legs that you can sort of move about, and then you'll be fully somebody, you know.
That's still not a robot body. That's robot arms and legs.
I don't know.
A body is a torso.
Yes. I'm telling you that I believe that it is that if I'm willing to bet on history, I'm gonna bet on the future, that I'm going to beat you because...
I tell you what, Mark, call me when they put somebody's decapitated head on a robot's body.
I'm going to say 20 years. That's how long I'm saying for that. I should live to see that. They're already talking about head transplants right now. It's in the news, Daryl. Look it up. Type in...
Yes, I know it's in the news.
Okay.
But, like, alien lizard people running the world is also in the news.
No,
it depends
not.
On what news you're looking at.
It does depend on what news you're looking at. If you're looking at stupid people news, then you're worried about alien lizards. If you're looking at mainstream news, you're seeing stories about people getting head transplants.
I've seen mainstream news carry... parody news because the copy guy in the newsroom is too much of a dum-dum to know that it was parody.
Do you think that's what's happening in the case of the head transplant?
I have no clue.
That's because you don't have any qualification to comment on this. You are a non-scientist.
And I also don't care.
Well, you should care.
I'm not getting my head transplanted onto anything. I don't want my head on a robot body.
Okay, then you don't have to have it. That's the good news is that it's going to cost a lot of money in the near term. At some point, it'll be brought down. But most humans have a desire to live longer than their average life expectancy. This is one of the real draws of religion, right? Like, religion's been offering this whole live forever thing for a very long time. It's just questionable as to whether or not they've been delivering.
Well, and it's also, you're living in the next life, not like your decrepit body now is being extended.
That's the best they could do. So here's what I'm saying is the robot body is a way for your brain to be, function for a course of decades until they can figure out some way to sort of cellularly rejuvenate the brain, if that's what they're going to do, or to take your consciousness and put it into something or whatever. And these are possibilities. I'm not saying that they're probabilities. Every time we take another step, it gets more difficult to predict it. But robot bodies, that is, I'm predicting 20 years and I think I'm giving myself some room.
So are you hoping that they upload your consciousness to the internet and then you can wind up making all of the telephones ring at the same time around the world because Lawnmower Man?
If they're uploading my consciousness to the internet, they've probably already uploaded the conscious. If my head has been preserved in a vat of liquid nitrogen,
right,
and then they bring me back and then put my consciousness on the internet, the chances are lots of people are already on the internet.
Let's say you're the guinea pig, though.
Fine.
They're like, we got to test it with something. Here's a brain that looks like it belonged to a mildly intelligent person.
Fine. I'll take...
Do you know how we know he's mildly intelligent? Because he chose Alcor.
Alcor.org. Let's go to Keith calling in from Colorado. You can call in about anything here on Free Talk Live. The number is 855-450-3733. Keith, what's on your mind?
Well, I was going to talk about the guy in England that was refusing to sing God Save the Queen. But
Jeremy Corbyn?
You guys are actually kind of on an interesting topic. I mean, do you really want your brain to be uploaded, your consciousness to be uploaded to the internet?
Yeah, I'll take that. I'll take that, sure.
I mean, what kind of safeguards do you put around your brain?
A skull.
Be silly.
Yeah.
What kind of safeguards? What's the question, Keith?
So let's say your brain and your consciousness is uploaded onto Facebook, for instance. I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay. So in 40 years, we're able to upload consciousness. Well, does anybody have the power to tap into anything you think?
Maybe.
I mean, that's, wow.
So the Mark Edge Googling Twitter would actually be controlled by Mark Edge's brain just randomly thinking of things that he wants to know.
It could very well be the case. What my guess would be is that if you're talking about being uploaded to the internet, you're talking about a virtual reality situation where you create your own living environment, you create your own, the people you hang out with. You know, you can bring back my dead dad and I can have a chat with him. It'd only be a computer, animation of my dead dad, but it'll do in that circumstance.
So we can't call that Second Life because that name's already taken. So what would you call this service?
I'll take Second Life. I don't know. Maybe Second Life will be repurposed for this very thing.
I'll take all my dirty thoughts for $500.
So, Keith, I mean, the only other option is death, right? I mean, that's the other option. And at that point, I will know what death is like because I will have lived in it for a period of time. I'll have had my head lopped off and be put in liquid nitrogen.
You're assuming they can successfully reanimate your brain after it's been in liquid nitrogen.
I'm going to assume that if you get cremated that they can't reanimate yours. That's what I'm assuming.
I'm not getting cremated. I want somebody to throw me in the ocean. I want a shark to eat me.
Thanks, Keith. Thanks for the call. What the hell does a shark want to do with you? They eat seals. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Tell me I'm crazy.
You're crazy.
If you own a business, you know incorporating can be a smart way to protect yourself and your assets. So the question is, why haven't you incorporated your business yet?
My business? It's too small.
Wrong. No matter how small your business, you run the risk of losing all your personal assets, your car, your home, even your entire life savings if you're not incorporated.
Incorporating is very complicated.
Actually, incorporating is easy and fast. You can do it in just 10 minutes. Call now for your free guide from incorporate.com. 1-800-945-8645.
I need a lawyer to incorporate. That's really expensive.
You don't need a lawyer, and we don't offer legal or financial advice. Incorporate.com is a service company whose only mission is helping people like you incorporate safely, easily, and quickly. Find out how simple it is to protect your family and personal assets by incorporating. Call now for your free guide. 1-800-945-8645. 1-800-945-8645. That's 1-800-945-8645.
No!
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Ready Supply Foods sells more food for your money than any other company, and we can prove it. We've gathered nutritional facts from our competitors' own websites and divided them by price to show you how much they sell per dollar. In an emergency, calories mean survival. Ready Supply Foods sells 245 calories per dollar, where the others average only 155. That's 58% more for your money. We're the new leader in value and quality. See the comparisons at ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about. What we're talking about right now is cutting off my head and putting it in a vat of liquid nitrogen. Well, at least that's what's going to happen at this point upon my death.
That's what's
going to
happen at the end of the show.
Well, you got to have privacy on the internet. So I'm recommending ProXPN. If you care about your privacy while on the internet, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt all of your online data before it even gets to your internet service provider. So before, as it's heading out of your computer, it's encrypted. They do it all right. They offer OpenVPN. That's the gold standard of network encryption. They've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android. There's even Linux support if you want it. So unlike the other guys, though, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities. ProXPN has even more servers than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. They accept credit cards and even Bitcoin. You can get 50% off of the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account. Lifetime, when you buy an annual account with our code, FTL50. You actually save a bit more if you use Bitcoin. It can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. You keep hearing about our online privacy being infringed. Go to proxpn.com now and protect yourself. Use coupon code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right. Proxpn.com, coupon code FTL50. So there is an article out that was sent to me by a listener about the false science of cryonics in the technologyreview.com. And it is written by a man who, he's a scientist. His main name is Michael Hendricks. And he kind of goes and picks apart the cryonics. Now, you know, what cryonics is like what I've said, is I've paid, I'm paying a monthly, or excuse me, an annual fee, and I think it's like $600 per year for a subscription. I do not necessarily recommend that young people make this decision. This might be a decision that is best made by older people. Here's the reason. Because you pay $600 a year as a subscription fee to sort of cover you. And then, but the fee for your preservation is the same. It's $80,000 to have your head preserved. I think it's $120,000 for your entire body.
So why didn't you opt for the entire body?
Because I don't want my body, especially if I die at 80. What do you want that body for? I'm going to go for the robot body because I believe robot bodies will be around before I even die.
How much does the robot body cost?
We don't have robot bodies to buy.
So you're hoping that they slap your head on something that you've not bought yet?
What are you talking about?
You said you want your head at some point put on a robot body.
I believe cars
You've not paid for the robot body. Are they just going to be handing out robot bodies for free down on the corner?
They may very well.
Outside the methadone clinic?
Son, if you have been if you're the first or even 100th person who is brought back to life from being cryonically frozen, you need to consider.
I don't think that's going to happen.
There isn't an army of these people out there. I don't care what you think. It either is going to happen or it is not going to happen. And what Daryl thinks today.
And
you know
in
what?
Either case.
I don't care what Tharg thinks about the wheel either. We're not talking about what you think. If you would have said, hey.
In either case, if I'm right, then nobody will ever know.
Right.
Listen, you will not know if I'm right.
If Ugg the caveman says, I don't think this fire thing is really going to turn into anything. I really prefer my food to be raw. Who cares? You are nothing but a caveman sitting next to a fire predicting what the future is going to be like. And you're not a particularly well-informed caveman. It's not like you're a scientist. You're a talk show host. I know what you do for a living. You call radio stations and ask them to put Free Talk Live on. Who cares what you think about science? Who cares what I think about science?
And my point is, if I'm right, neither of us will ever know that I'm right.
That much is true, because I'll be dead and you'll be dead.
Yes.
However, if my head is...
Tell me what the science guy thinks.
If my head's preserved in a vat of liquid nitrogen, I might come back and you won't, because you'll be
yeah,
like...
Yeah, and if your head's preserved in liquid nitrogen and somebody drops it on the way to the robot body, it shatters into itty-bitty little pieces.
Yep, but I still had a better chance than you, because your body's been fed to worms. Let's go on here with the article.
Giant sea worms.
Whatever. You won't get to decide what happens to your body, my friend, especially if you have weird requests. There's all kinds of stories of people's requests of where they're buried to not being met.
I'll pay somebody to put me in a boat.
Fine. Let's see. Going on here with the,
and you'll light it on fire gladly.
Yeah. From Technology Review. I woke up on Saturday to a heartbreaking front-page article of the New York Times about a terminally ill young woman who chooses to freeze her brain. She's drawn into a cottage industry spurred by transhumanist principles that offer to preserve people in liquid nitrogen immediately after their death and store their bodies, at least their heads, in hopes that they can be reanimated or digitally replicated in a technologically advanced future. Proponents have added to a patina of scientific plausibility to this by citing the promise of new technologies in neuroscience, particularly recent work in connectomics, a field that maps the connections between neurons. The suggestion that a detailed map of neural connections could be enough to restore a person's mind, memories, and personality by uploading it to a computer simulation. Science tells us that a map of connections is not sufficient to stimulate, let alone replicate, a nervous system. You'll have the nervous system, or at least the main part of it, the brain, right there. I don't know what his argument is here.
Well, if they don't go far enough down on, like, C5 or whatever, then, like, it's all shot.
What about, yes, I'm sure that they're saving the right amount of spinal cord there are people that don't have use of their spinal cords. Their spinal cords are severed, and we still call them people. They still have emotions. They still roll about and do things. So they exist. I study a small roundworm, and he gives the scientific name of this roundworm, and I don't know much about it, which is by far the best described animal in all of biology. We know all of its genes and all of its cells, a little over 1,000 of them. We know the identity and complete synaptic connectivity of its 302 neurons. We have known this for 30 years. If we could upload or roughly simulate any brain, it would be that of this Elegansis.
Roundworm. Just call it a roundworm.
This roundworm. Yet even with the full connectome in hand, static model of this network of connections lacks most of the information necessary to stimulate the mind of the worm. In short, brain activity cannot be inferred by synaptic neuroanatomy. So he's, you know, saying sciencey stuff to basically say, look, we can't, the most basic of creatures of which we know the most now, we still can't bring them back to life. And I get where he's coming from. I don't expect that if I miss the singularity or whatever moment it is where people's lives are extended the next stretch, because the futurists are currently claiming that it'll be about the time that I'm going to die that we'll make this next big step where humans go from, say, living about 80 years to living about 120, giving me another 40 years for the next scientific advance. And, you know, younger people than that, they get a better shot. Older people, less of a shot. All I'm saying is the cryonics is a little bit of insurance. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to alkavision.com to find out more. That's alkavision.com.
Hi, this is Walt Augustinowicz. I'm the founder and CEO of ID Stronghold. By now you've heard our commercials about wallets that protect you from electronic pickpocketing. 10 years ago, I created a way to protect my own cards from prying eyes after government officials started talking about issuing a national ID card with a built-in radio chip called RFID. I felt having to broadcast my personal information was an invasion of privacy. Soon after, it was also announced that credit cards, debit cards, U.S. passports, hotel room keys, and even transit passes would all soon incorporate RFID. It was then I formed ID Stronghold to share my inventions in blocking RFID signals with the world. There are a lot of misconceptions out there today about RFID. I encourage everyone to get informed and get protected. Please go to idstronghold.com and get the facts and the wallets, sleeves, or badge holders you need to protect your personal financial data. You'll be pleasantly surprised that through our direct sales model, you won't pay more than other comparable unprotected wallets. It is as though the protection is free. Visit idstronghold.com today.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's 855-450-FREE. And this evening we're talking about eternal life. Well, not the kind of eternal life you might have been sold in your religious education, but perhaps the kind you're getting sold now through the science of cryonics. Now, I'm using air quotes. I don't know.
So let me ask this question.
Go ahead.
If I do opt to get my head frozen, would I still have earwax?
I would assume, my guess is if they're preserving your head, they're probably just preserving your brain, or your brain and maybe some spinal cord, that kind of thing, that they probably aren't going to have much use for your head, and that, you know, the rest of your head besides your brain isn't terribly useful.
Well, the rest of the head sort of, you know, like, protects the brain from getting squished, nibbled on by mice.
Yeah, I understand that bones are, you know, bone like the skull. It's useful.
Yes, bones are very useful.
When you're talking about, you know, several hundred million years ago in the evolutionary chain. But now we have things like steel, titanium, and better things to protect your brain with than a bone skull.
Okay, Wolverine.
All I'm saying is that, you know, maybe there's some technological advances to this body that that we have. People, there's a lot of people with glasses listening to the show. You know, they're basically transhumanists. They're augmenting themselves. Yeah, you got something
to say? That's a stretch of a definition of transhumanist.
Yeah, well, fine. You can choose that that's a stretch if that's what you wish to do. Certainly there are people running around with artificial hearts.
Yes.
That's not a stretch.
That would be correct.
There you go. And if you're going to come back from death, you might want to have a little savings, maybe some gold stashed some place. Well, you can get some gold at gold.freetalklive.com. We've got a relationship with Midas Resources. They're actually the syndicate of our show, and I've been doing business with them for many years, and it's always been great. So gold.freetalklive.com for great rates and on gold and silver pieces. When I first looked into gold and silver, I had a very difficult time sort of pricing one against another. We make it easy for you over there, gold.freetalklive.com.
So let me ask this question, because
we're talking about cryonics here. This is my head being lopped off at the end of my life and put in a nitrogen chamber. Now, I would like to point out, my mother won't go for this. My wife won't go for this. Everybody thinks this is weird.
I'm glad I'm not the only person that thinks this is weird. But I've got a question, because you said if you're going to freeze your head, you might want some savings for when you get unfrozen after you are dead. If you die, don't you cease to be the owner of the possessions in which you acquired before you died and got your brain dropped in liquid nitrogen?
Hey, you know, if I got to start over, I guess I have to start over.
So what's the point of being like, I'm buying a bunch of silver to take with me to the cryogenic lab?
If you're the one that knows where the key to the safe deposit box is, you're the owner of it.
But what if somebody at the safe deposit box is like, safe deposit box company's going out of business, everything gets sold?
There's always a what if. Daryl, this is certainly a what if scenario. If you're getting your head lopped off and put in a vat of liquid nitrogen, you have already entered the realm of what if.
Yes.
Right? Here's where you're not in the realm of what if, because this is important. Because when you're looking at cryonics, you have to look at it alongside of reality. And reality is, when you're dead, you're effing dead. There hasn't been one person that's come back yet. Not one. So you know that dead is dead. However, cryonics is possibly alive in the future. That's the difference.
So you're going to be like Schrodinger's corpse.
Well, I guess you would be. Well, you know, you'd be in the vat, and you'd be definitely dead in the vat. You would either be brought back in the future or you wouldn't. If the box is the future, then I suppose you'd be Schrodinger's corpse. But this is a rather esoteric comparison. Let me go on with Michael Hendrickson's critique of cryonics.
He's the science guy?
He's the science guy writing this article, this biased article over at technologyreview.com.
You're only saying it's biased because it's not telling you what you want to hear.
I'm going to tell you it's biased because he doesn't address the important issues. Because when Michael Hendrickson is dead, he's dead. Right?
You're saying it's biased because it's not telling you what you want to hear. If it was telling you what you wanted to hear, you would not say it's a biased article.
No.
Because it's telling you what Mark Edge wants to hear.
He's not looking at this from the standpoint of somebody who is buying. He's looking at this from the standpoint of somebody who wants to tear it down, and that's fine.
That's what good science does, is you try to tear things down, and then if it reconstructs itself, then okay, it's
solid. You can't
reconstruct
something that is conjecture about the future.
But you can reconstruct, we're trying to replicate this worm's brain, and we can't do it, so therefore we failed at replicating the brain.
That's true. He says earlier in the article that basically there's this worm that they've studied for 30 years. They know everything about its DNA, everything about its cells. It exists. You know, in science, it's the most studied thing in the world. They can't bring it back to life. They're not even close to bringing it back to life. And some of the claims that cryonics makes are way ahead of their time. Let me go on with what he says here. The features of your, and while it might be theoretically possible to preserve those features in dead tissue, that certainly is not happening now. The technology to do so, let alone the ability to read this information back out of such assessment, does not exist even in principle. It is this purposeful conflation of what is theoretically conceivable with what is ever practically possible that exploits people's vulnerability. Finally, would you, if you were uploaded to the internet, would you really be you? This is unanswerable, but we can dip our toes in. Whatever our subjective sense of self is, let's assume it arises from the operation of the physical matter of your brain. We could also tentatively conclude that such awareness is substrate neural. I don't know what that means. If brains can be conscious, a computer program that does everything a brain does should be conscious too. So this is interesting, right? Like if your consciousness is uploaded to the internet from your brain, what happens to the consciousness that's in your brain? Does your consciousness reside in your brain? And if so, how could it be uploaded? And if it can be uploaded, is there still consciousness that resides there? Do you understand what I'm saying? Like people basically consciousness.
Right, so can you make a copy of it? Because
copy's different.
Hold on. I can make a copy of any file on my computer and put it on the internet.
Right.
The file does not cease to be on my computer unless I delete it from my computer.
Right.
So the similarity here is if you upload a copy of the consciousness, are you just sending a copy to the internet?
Right.
Or are you at the same time deleting it from the brain?
Right. And this is, you know, fascinating because part of what consciousness is, at least in our understanding of it today, is it exists in one place. And if it begins to exist in two places, is it even the same thing? Now, the scientist questions this and has no way to answer the question. So I don't know the answer. He doesn't either. And I just feel like in his all of his, you know, those are his basically his things. And then he talks about the price of $80,000.
So part of this seems especially the, you know, like upload the brain to the internet sort of thing seems kind of like the Matrix, only it's slightly different in that, you know, in the movie. In the movie The Matrix, it was not voluntary whether or not you were uploaded to the internet. But if you die in the Matrix, you die in real life.
Yeah.
So if your consciousness is uploaded to the internet and it somehow still resides in your brain and there's a copy on the internet doing whatever, and you know, you in whatever internet world you're in die, then does your brain be like, okay, I'm dead now, and cease to function?
Doesn't seem likely. If you're in a video game and you die, you're not dead, you just respawn. So I would think that if whatever...
But your brain is not uploaded to the video game.
If it's war, and there, the parameters of that war are you die, then you die. But if the parameters are of the program that you don't die, then you don't die, is the answer to your question. 855-450-3733. Do you have any questions or comments on the idea of cryonics? Because I know a little bit.
Now is the time to save on hardwood and more at Lumber Liquidators End of Summer Clearance Sale. We're making room for new fall inventory. That means it's your chance to get an incredible deal on solid, pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents. Wide plank, hand-scraped oak for $1.99. Beautiful carbonized bamboo for $1.29. Plus, get 10 to 15% off Morningstar Bamboo, the number one selling brand of bamboo flooring. Top quality laminate and vinyl plank from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. Hurry, the End of Summer Clearance Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
So I found out the other day that at Guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to Guns80.com now.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hi, my name is Scott Fuchs, teacher and rowing coach for over 14 years. I was sluggish, overweight, on prescription drugs, and only 30-something. Fortunately, I was referred to Dr. Z, and happy to say Dr. Z's all-natural protocols over a consistent course resolved my health issues. I'm in the best shape of my life, and most importantly, on zero medications.
I'm Dr. Zdanowski, author of Evology. Trained as a primary care physician, surgical manipulation under anesthesia, expert in nutrition, diet, weight loss, immune system, and I specialize in chiropractic. My 15 years of professional experience has taught me the four keys to vibrant health: a balanced musculoskeletal system, an integrated nervous system, a flowing lymphatic system, and a body filled with over 90 essential nutrients. This has been a secret too long. Actualize your potential, reverse disease. Call me, Dr. Z. 201-945-1177, 201-945-1177, evolveyourself.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
That is not done by other programs out there. You know, they got the red team or the blue team, and they root for them. We don't. We root for you. We believe that you are the best person to make the choices for your life. If you believe that what we do is a good thing, you want to see this message in competition with these other radio shows out there on more radio stations, the best thing to do is to join our AMP program. We've got perks there at the AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. You'll get commercial-free broadcast, and there's a great Facebook group that Ian and I are very active in. So you kind of become the board of directors for Free Talk Live by joining the AMP program. It's $5 a month, and it's very doable. amp.freetalklive.com. We're talking about cryonics, and that is the freezing of your body or brain after death. And I have signed up to do this, and I want to tell people why. I've just read an article here from this guy, Michael Hendricks, and he says that basically no one who has experienced the disbelief of losing a loved one can help but sympathize with someone who pays $80,000 to freeze their brain. But reanimation or simulation is an abjectly false hope that is beyond the promise of technology and is certainly impossible with the frozen dead tissue offered by the cryonics industry. Those who profit from this hope deserve our anger and contempt. So he is not sold, as it were. And I want to tell you why I picked it, because I am not sold after hearing his arguments. He may be right, but the fact is that when you die, you're dead, and that's it. So far, nobody's been brought back, and it seems unlikely that anyone will be brought back that is, say, cremated or something.
I don't think anybody is trying to say that if you get cremated, we can bring you back to life in 40 years.
So I would ask the question is when we see the advances in medical technology, do we think that people will be reanimated in the future? We already see people being brought back from death currently, right? I mean, people are dead for a short period of time. They're brought back. Now, the question
is...
Hold on.
So you just contradicted yourself in like a span of four sentences.
Okay. Yes, I'm talking about people being cremated, Daryl. When you're dead in that sense.
No, the opening was nobody's been brought back from being dead. Okay. And then four sentences later, you said, we're already seeing people that wind up getting brought back from being dead.
What I'm trying to show is that there's a continuum. We are in a continuum of time, and we don't know what the future will bring.
Yes.
Currently, people are being brought back sometimes after a short period of time of death.
Yes.
The question is in the future, will more people be brought back or fewer? And the chances are high that it will be more. And you got to ask yourself, will a stretch of time be longer? Will somebody be brought back after a day? Will somebody be brought back after a week? And these kind of things. Now, I don't know.
Will somebody be able to be brought back 40 years later?
These are questions. Now, I'm not talking about 40 years. I'm talking about 200. Because
you've got to get to 40 before you get to 200.
Fine. So medical advances from 100 years ago, from the turn of the 1900s the turn of the 19th century to the 20th century to now are incredible.
Yes.
If we think about those next 115 years and what those are going to bring in 2130, we have no idea what medicine is going to look like there. But it's a relatively short period of time in human
history.
And
we also don't know if the guy that has the jars of liquid nitrogen is going to necessarily keep really good records for his, successor at the brain storage company.
Well, this is something I did check. At this point, Alcor is a very good company. There are other companies, and they haven't done as well. But so far, they've managed to keep track of who and what they've got, and no one's been lost and those sorts of things.
Are they still going to be in business in 115 years?
That's the purpose of the foundation that is involved in them. That's what you're paying for. So the answer is, at this point, it looks that way. And now the question you have to ask yourself, if scientists have the ability to bring somebody who's long dead back, where are they going to start?
Walt Disney.
Ted Williams. Ted Williams is a place to start, but they probably actually won't start on Ted Williams.
Why Albert Einstein.
Albert Einstein's brain's been sliced into little thin slices like American cheese.
Okay, I can't think of anybody else famous who had their brain frozen.
Right. Well, that's what I'm saying is they're going to go to the frozen people because that's the best preserved brain. They're not going to go to the cremated people because there is no brain. They're not going to go to the buried people because the brain's been eaten by worms.
They're not going to go to Congress because there is no brain.
Right. So they're going to go to the preserved brains. And they're either going to succeed or they're going to fail in bringing somebody back. And that's the only thing that I've ever said for myself. $80,000 is a relatively small amount of money to sort of leave at one's death. It's not impressive. Now, you can buy a big pointy stone or a stone with angels or carve whatever on your tombstone. You can have that. You can have a monument to yourself. You may be maybe you give something to an important government building and have your name on it. Or you can attempt to or you can give it to your kids who are probably a bunch of ingrates and will never learn to work for themselves if you give them a large sum of money. Or you can attempt to see whether or not you can forward the science of life preservation. And that's all I've tried to do with cryonics. And, you know, my hope is I don't need to. My hope is that I never have my head lopped off and put into a vat of liquid nitrogen. Because life extension comes before that. But I don't know.
I think when people
are presented with the idea of longer life, they're always going to take it.
I can just imagine now in, you know, like 200-300 years, the head of Mark Edge, or rather the brain that was placed in some sort of robotic head made out of adamantium, doing the voice of a commercial saying, I'm not just the president of the head lopping off society. I'm also a client.
I liked it so much, I bought the company. Yeah, it's laughable because Futurama did that thing with the heads in jars, and Star Trek actually had one with that too. It is funny. There's no doubt it's funny, but to me, it seems like a reasonable thing to do. It was presented with the idea by a guy named Perry at an event where he was talking about sort of transhumanism. And I'm like, yeah, that makes more sense than not doing it. And when you think about this, I didn't give them $80,000 to preserve my head. I bought a life, and you don't do that until it's time to lop your head off, right? I bought a life insurance policy for $100,000. This is a relatively normal thing to do.
Yes.
When that life insurance, they're just the beneficiary of $80,000 of it. Now, this is whole life, so when it's paid off or whatever. Some people say that whole life isn't worth doing. You should do term. I just wanted it done and put out of the way.
Term, you're basically betting that you're going to die in the next period of years.
Well, different people have different preferences. It's my understanding the term is the better choice financially, but I just wanted it paid off in 20 years and then done. And so I'm not paying $80,000. I'm paying a certain amount for life insurance. And if I decide to reallocate those funds at any point, I can do that. Now, I don't recommend people go and young people rush in to get sign up for the cryonics now, because at that point you're betting you're going to die in a terrible fashion, right? It's going to be an accident that kills you.
Well, most of the young people now will scream YOLO before running and doing something stupid. So
if you're screaming YOLO, you're not going to do cryonics, right? YOLO isn't a cryonics cry. You know, these are people that want to live forever, and you only live once. Let's do something stupid is not that kind of personality type.
True.
So what I'm saying is that if you think you're getting into that percentile of areas where you could die, I don't know what the age group is. You got to decide that for yourself. But I wear on my wrist a little medical bracelet that tells them exactly what to do with my body.
In case of death, call Alcor.
They really say that. In case of death, see reverse for biostasis protocol. And it tells them to shoot me up with heparin, whatever the hell that is. And it's 50,000 U heparin by
units.
IV. Or do CPR while cooling with ice in order to keep pH 7.5, whatever, no embalming and no autopsy. So these are the things that are sort of in the contract for cryonics. And, you know, that's the agreement I made with my wife. Now, I'd like to live forever, so I wish my wife would sign up too. But she doesn't want to do that. And that's
just
up to
find
her.
A hot robot wife.
Yep, indeed, that could happen. The future is going to be a crazy place. In the meantime, check us out at our Facebook page at facebook.freetalklive and see the regular webpage at freetalklive.com. It's been Mark with you.
And Daryl.
Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com. If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Is negative content or comments on the web affecting your personal or professional reputation? Unfavorable comments, embarrassing pictures, videos, legal documents, and bad tweets can ruin your personal life, your career, or your business. It happens a lot, and it's just not fair. But what can you do? Reputation.com can protect your good name. Get a free consultation now at 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. Call right now for a free expert reputation analysis. It's easy to squash the unfair attacks with our patented system, and the analysis is absolutely free. Make the best things about you jump out in searches. Protect your personal and professional reputation, your business, and your income. Get your free reputation analysis from Reputation.com right now. Call 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771. 800-831-0771.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Be sure to visit GCNLive.com today.